Alrighty then, back with another classic. Today, I'm checking out Steel, starring Shaquille O'Neal. Originally, a lot of people thought this movie was trash, but come on, man, give Shaq a chance. It's not like we're asking him to shoot free throws or anything. Aww. Anyway, so the film opens up with John Henry Irons, a weapons designer for the United States military who designs high-tech weapons for combat. One day, a soldier named Burke, yes, the guy from Breakfast Club, wants to show the full potential of one of the weapons and fires it full blast into an abandoned building. However, somehow the weapon backfires and destroys the one the soldiers are standing in, causing huge chunks of debris to fall, one of which crushes Iron's friend Sparky. Later on, in court, Burke is discharged for what happened, and due to Sparky now being paralyzed, Irons resigns from the military. After this, Burke decides to start selling Irons weapons to gangs in the area. Then, one night out on the street, Iron sees a gang rob a bank using his tech and chases them to their hideout. But he's not able to find out who gave them the weapons. He then visits Sparky in the hospital, and together, they plan to assemble weapons to combat the criminals. With the help of his Uncle Joe, who runs a scrapyard, Irons creates a suit of armor. No, not this one. This one. And becomes Steel, vowing to take down the criminals. He confronts the robbers again, but is subdued by his own weapons and is later arrested for this. Great job, Shaq. Burke then plans to sell all of Iron's weapons to criminals over the internet. Wait a minute, do they have internet in 1997? Anyway, Irons gets released and he and Sparky go after Burke. Once they raid his hideout, Steel and Burke engage into a confrontation, with Burke getting killed by a rogue laser blast. Following that, Colonel David, who is in charge of Iron's unit in the beginning of the movie, offers for Steel to help the military. But once he realizes that it's Irons, he's like, oh, yeah. And then, Irons declines the offer anyway. The film ends with Irons' grandmother opening a new restaurant in town, and Sparky showing off a new wheelchair that allows her to walk, pretty much like Rhodey in Civil War. The end. You know what? I thought it was good. Yeah, it's cheesy. Yes, it's Shaq. But come on, guys. For the 90s, it's all we had, man. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this one, and I'll see you later.